Good morning, children. I hope all of you are keeping fine, fit and healthy and staying at home. And this is a very tough time. We all have to go with it. So, we are starting with the very first lesson of Flamingo, the last lesson. The last lesson written by Alphonse Daudet. This tells us how much important it is to hold on to one's identity and culture and not losing it or taking it for granted. The last lesson is set in the days of the French-Prussian War, 1870-1871, led by Bismarck. Prussia defeated France and the French districts of Alsace and Lorraine passed into the Prussian hands. The two protagonists in the story, M. Hamel and French, belong to Alsace. M. Hamel is a French language teacher at a school and Franz is one of his students. The story revolves around how the war proves to be a life-altering event for both. Now let's have a summary of the lesson. The narrator Franz started the school very late that morning. He feared M. Hamel. He would question the students on participles. The narrator didn't know even the first word about them. He feared his scolding. He thought of running away and spending the time out of doors. The weather was very warm and bright, but he decided otherwise and hurried off to school. On his way to school, Franz passed the town hall and noticed a crowd in front of the bulletin board. For the past 2 years, all the bad news had come from it, and Franz thought about what the matter was that time. As he was hurrying past, the blacksmith called out to him and said that there was plenty of time to reach the school. Franz thought that he was making fun of him and reached the school panting. Usually, when the school began, there was a lot of hustle and bustle. The opening and closing of desks and lessons were really repeated in unison, creating a lot of commotion. But now it was all so still. He could depend on the commotion to get to his desk without being noticed. But now he went in before everybody. He blushed and was quite frightened. But nothing happened. No punishment. M. Hamel saw him and asked very kindly and politely to take his seat. Franz was very much shocked and confused. What is happening? Hamel was in clothes that he wore only on inspection and prize days. The whole school seemed so strange and silent. But the most surprising thing was the presence of the village elders sitting quietly on the back benches. M. Hamel mounted his chair and spoke in a grave and gentle tone. My children, this is the last lesson I shall give you. He told them that an order had come from Berlin. Only German would be taught in the schools of Alsace and Lorraine. The new master would come the next day. It was their last French lesson. He wanted them to be very attentive. The narrator felt sorry for not learning his lessons in French. He never liked his books. He didn't have any interest in grammar and history. But now he developed a fascination for them. Even he started liking M. Hamel. The idea that he would not teach them anymore made Franz forget all about his ruler. He even forget how cranky his teacher was. Now, it was his turn to recite, but he got mixed up and confused. To his surprise, Hamel didn't scold him. M. Hamel showed his concern that people of Alsace and generally gave no importance to French. They put off learning their own native language. French was not the only culprit. Many others also shared the same fate. He also blamed himself for this. Often, he sent his students to water his garden or gave them a holiday whenever he wanted to go for fishing. He declared that the French language was the most beautiful language in the world. It was the clearest and most logical. They must guard it among themselves and never forget it. It appeared that M. Hamel wanted to give them all he knew among themselves and never forget it. It appeared that M. Hamel wanted to give them all he knew before going away. M. Hamel opened a grammar book and taught them their last lesson. Franz was amazed to see how well he understood everything. Franz thought that probably he never paid much attention in the class, and that M. Hamel had never explained everything with so much patience. After that, they had a lesson in writing. M. Hamel had brought new copies for them that day. Everyone was immersed in their work. Even the little children sitting in the class were tracing their fish books as if that was French too. All at once, the church clock struck 12. The trumpets of the Prussian soldiers sounded under their windows. M. Hamel stood up, very pale, in his chair. He tried to speak, but something choked him. He couldn't speak. Then he turned to the blackboard. He took a piece of chalk and wrote as large as he could. Vive la France. That means long live France. Then without a word, he made a gesture to them with his hand. School is dismissed. You may go. Now with this, we come to the end of the story. The message of the story is that the story carries the message of the importance of holding on to one's identity and culture and not losing it or taking it for granted. It emphasizes the importance of holding on to one's language as the key to our identity. It highlights the importance of one's language in preserving our heritage and history. Now, here is a character sketch of the two protagonists of the lesson. M. Hamel, just go with it. Now, this is the character sketch of Franz. If you wish, like, if you find some more, you can add to it. Here is the story in nutshell for your recap. Just enjoy the story. Here you will find some word meaning to understand the lesson better. These are not all. Just read the chapter. You will find many more words difficult. Consult the dictionary and enhance your vocabulary. Some question answers are here. These are not all. You can add some more to it. Now we come to the self-assessment. Some questions are given. Read the chapter to understand the lesson in a better way and write down these questions in your fair copy. That's all, children. Enjoy your e-learning. Thank you.